Hello and welcome to Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. With me, your host today, Nina. I am back. I hope everybody is having a fantastic day so far. If you can, just get in that comments box, introduce yourself, tell us where in the world you are watching from. Tell us what you're up to today. How's the weather? It is a beautiful sunny day where I am in the northwest of England in the United Kingdom. So do let us know how you are. If you are just joining us, this is Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. A big welcome to everybody watching us on Facebook or on YouTube. Thank you so much for all the words that you have sent in so far. If you haven't had a chance to do that, don't worry. Please get in the comments box and add your words in now, and I will try and get through as many as I can. It is Thursday, the 2nd of December. It is 1:30 and it is Pronunciation Live. This is the show where you send us the words that you have difficulty pronouncing and we help you to pronounce them. Okay, so just a few points. One of our viewers asked if I could sit really close to the camera so that you could see my mouth clearly. That is one way that you can help with your pronunciation, is just watching the position of the mouth. But also, if you have a pair of headphones, please make sure you pop them in and turn the volume up nice and loud so you can hear clearly. If you don't have headphones, don't worry. Just make sure that the volume is at a comfortable but loud level where you can hear. In terms of accents, so I am a native speaker of English, and therefore I will be able to model the words with a native British accent. But it is an accent. Everybody who speaks English will speak with an accent. And so you might hear some slight differences, but it's good to expose yourself to a wide range of accents so you can understand the different ways in that English is spoken. Also, to point out that this is a pronunciation show, so I will not spend a lot of time going through the meanings of different words. But if there is a new word that you're not sure of the meaning, do take a note and you can check it in the dictionary after the show. Of course, you can take advantage of all the resources on BBC Learning English to improve your vocabulary and English in general, such as the vocabulary show on Monday at 1:30. As well as the grammar class on Wednesday or the quiz on Friday. But thank you for joining us today for Pronunciation Live. So let's take a look at some of the comments and see who we've got here. Hi, Maria. Nice to see you. Hello, everybody from Italy. We've also got Helen from El Salvador. Thanks for joining us. Pashu in Kurdistan. Thanks for joining us. Kashu, nice to see you today. We have got Sai from Myanmar. Thank you for joining us. Christian says, hi, Nina. Hi, Christian. Thank you for joining us and taking the time to improve your pronunciation today. Hi, Sai from Burma. Hi, Maseri. Luca, hope I'm saying your name right. Thanks for joining us today. Hello, Dang from Vietnam. Hello, Hamant from India. Nice for you to join us. Thanks for letting us know where you are watching from. Hi, Amar from Algeria. Thank you very much for joining us. And Davin Beck, thank you very much. Hi, nice to see you. Thanks for all your comments. Fantastic, so many people here. Anika says, hi, Mom. Hi, Anika, nice to see you. We have got Omar from Mexico. Hi, Omar and everybody else watching from Mexico. Glad you can join us. Hi, Fatih from Turkey. And hello to everybody who is watching us from Turkey. We've got Jenna Rosso from Brazil and also Jane from Brazil. Thank you for joining us. And Piyari in Nepal. Thank you. And everybody who is joining us today. Now, before we get on with your words, let's take a look at today's challenge. So these were some different words that were sent in by a few of you. And what I want to know today is which of the following words have the same pronunciation? Which of the following words have the same pronunciation? So do get in the comments and share your ideas. I'm not going to say the words yet. You're going to have to say them to yourself and think about which of these words are what we call homophones, which means words that are spelt differently, but have the same sound. Okay. All right. So we will come back and look at that at the end of the show. Let's start with the words that you have sent in today. So Erba wanted to know how to pronounce the word maybe. 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 Thanks very much, Erba, for sending in your words. Salikaka wanted to know how to say the word shuddered. 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 So this means to shake, usually in fear, if you shudder. And in the past tense, it would be shuddered. Shuddered. Okay, we have got this word sent in by Tuntun. Thank you very much. We've got two words actually from Tuntun. We've got corridor. Corridor. So the stress, Tuntun, is on the first syllable. Corridor. And we've got chef. Chef. This word causes people a little bit of trouble in English because it doesn't have that typical ch sound, even though we've got ch. That's because this word was borrowed from French. And so we pronounce it how the French might pronounce it, with a sh. Chef. 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 Thank you very much, Tuntun, for sending those in. Viet wanted to know how to pronounce the words exclamation mark. So, and there is an exclamation mark there for you to look at. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. So this X sound is a k, 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 and a s together. So X, X, X. And then it's quite difficult because we've got to put in another vowel sound. X, k, 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 X. So we're going back to the k. And then the L, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark. So I hope that helps, Viet. A couple of difficult words for you there. Spring had sent in these two words. So we've got abscond, abscond, and abjure. You might say abscond, but because the stress is on the second syllable, it's weakened. So we've got abscond. Abscond, and the same sounds at the beginning of your second word, spring, is abjure, abjure. So to abscond means to run away, especially if you are trying to avoid a crime. So she absconded with the money. To abjure would be to publicly announce that you were denying something, or maybe that you, for example, had abjured your religion if you no longer supported your religion, for example. Okay, let's go back and look at some of the words that we have got in the comments that you have sent in. Let's see what we've got here. We've still got lots of people saying hi. We've got Tam from Vietnam. We've got Ian also from Turkey. We've got Abugata. Thank you very much. Nice to hear from you too. Okay, let's take a look who else we've got here. We've got Raja from Pakistan. Thank you for joining us. Dara says they like British culture. I'm glad you like British culture. We've got Abdullah. Hello from Leicester City. Okay, much closer to me than some of these other comments are coming from. We've got Sohag from Bangladesh. Fantastic. If you are just joining us, this is Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. Please do send in the words that you would like help with pronouncing. If we go back to today's challenge, we do have a few answers in here. So Mick is saying that these two words have the same sound. What do you think? Do you agree with Mick or not? Okay, Avsalov is saying that these two words have the same sound. And I'm sorry, I cannot pronounce your name. I can't read those characters, but this viewer is saying that these have the same sound. Okay, so quite a few different answers. We've got Hien saying these two words have the same sound. Wayne thinks these two words have the same sound. Jessica thinks these two words have the same sound. Ahmed thinks these two words have the same sound. Okay, and we've got Lindang who thinks both these pairs of words have the same sound. What do you think? Okay, and we've got Isan who is absolutely sure that these two words have the same sound. Are you as sure as Isan? What do you think? Send your answers in. Okay, at the end of the show, we will be coming back to take a look at which of you with all these comments is correct. Now, Mingfong has sent in some more connected speech. Thank you very much, Ming. So Ming, I think, was watching a post that went out on BBC Learning English called What to Say When Catching Up. So when you want to catch up with somebody, what do you say? And Ming was a little bit confused about how these words sound when they run together. So I'm going to look at these separately, Ming. One of these was, what have you been up to? What have you been up to? When we say the words separately, this is how we say them. But Ming, you are totally right. When we say these together in fluent English, the sounds do change. So what have? Have is just a grammar word. So it is not stressed. It becomes weak and it changes to have. Have. So we've got that that schwa sound in there. Have. Have. So we've got what have. What have. But very often when we have a T at the end of the word and an H of certain words, not all words, but words like have or him or her, very often the H is then dropped. So instead of what of, what have, sorry, we've got what of, what of, what have you been up to? What have you been up to? What of? What have you been up to? So I hope that helps, Ming. What have you been up to? And you might also notice that been sounds more like been. What have you been up to? What have you been up to? So I hope that helps. And the second one was, how have you been? Again, when we run these separately, how have you been? They sound like that. But when we speak quickly in fluent English, how have you been? How have you been? So some people might say, how have you been? How have you been? And some people might actually run that together even more, how have. How have. So again, that H is dropped and the consonant, the W at the end of how, connects in. So how have. How have you been? How have you been? Or how have you been? How have you been? Thank you very much, Ming, for sending those in, and I hope that helped. Now, Evgeny sent this in. Possibly, Evgeny, you were watching Tim's pronunciation workshop, also posted on BBC Learning English Facebook page yesterday, I believe. And this was white piece of paper. But you might notice that when we run these together, the T is lost. So when we have a T at the end of one word and a P at the beginning of the next word, white piece becomes white piece. White piece. White piece. White piece. White piece of paper. So those join together. So I hope that helps. Win. Some interesting words sent in here. These are all things that grow. So the first word here is laburnum. Laburnum. Laburnum, which is a type of tree, a very beautiful yellow tree. I had a laburnum tree growing in my garden when I was a kid. I remember it being very bright and beautiful. Laburnum. Laburnum. And the second word is bougainvillea. Bougainvillea, not a very common word in English. It is a group of plants, a name for a type of plants, bougainvillea. And a little bit more common is something that we eat a lot here in the UK, which is cauliflower. 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 So I hope that helps. All right. While I'm going back to your comments, I will just put up today's challenge again. And we'll see what answers you were given here. So Abdus Mia thinks these two have the same sounds. And Rosemary thinks these two have the same sound. What do you think? Have a go at saying all these words individually. Which of them do you think sound the same? Sandeep would like to know how to pronounce the word Conscious. So if you are aware of something, you are conscious of it. Thank you for sending that in. Shadman would like to know how to pronounce these two. So we've got the same sounds at the beginning, shh, and the same sounds at the end, p. But in the first one, we've got sheep, sheep. So if you kind of make this smile shape with your mouth, sheep. And the second one is I, ship, ship. Sheep, sheep, and ship. Okay, Helen, I don't know if this is what you want to eat or what you want to learn how to pronounce. It is vegetables, vegetables, and butter. Vegetables and butter. Vegetables. So it's not vegetables. Vegetables. We run it together. It is a three-syllable word. Vegetables. Raushan would like to know how to pronounce considerable. 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 And if you run that together quickly, considerable. Or even considerable. Considerable. Okay. Thank you very much for sending that in. Sandeep would like to know how to pronounce picturesque. Picturesque. So if something is so beautiful that you could take a picture of it, it is picturesque. Ty would like to know how to pronounce the word insomnia. Insomnia. Ty, I hope you don't have insomnia. It is horrible when you do. It is a condition that means that you cannot sleep. Insomnia. Insomnia. And Gia, okay, the three verb parts of this verb are choose, in the past tense, chose, and in the past participle, chosen. So choose, chose, chosen. Good words to send in as they are easily confused. Okay. This word. So again, we have another pronunciation of the word ch. Sometimes it's ch. In the example of chef, it was sh, sh. And this one is with a k sound. So we've got chaos, chaos, chaos. So again, when we borrow words from other languages, especially if a word comes from Greek, the ch will be pronounced with a k sound, chaos. Angel, these words are pronounced the same. So we've got our, our, and hour. Okay, so an hour meaning 60 minutes or belonging to us, hour, but they have the same pronunciation. Moon, the pronunciation of this word is asked, asked, asked. So even though there is a D at the end of this word, it is pronounced with a T sound, T. Okay, so asked, asked. So when the last consonant of a verb is unvoiced, k, k. When we have ed, it will make a t, t sound. Thanks very much for sending that in. Irikatia would like to know how to pronounce the word appetite. Appetite, thank you very much. And Sandeep, we've got the word gesture. Gesture, gesture. Shilpa would like to know how to pronounce the word chores. So this is much more how we expect the ch sound in English. Ch-ch-ch, chores. Okay, ch, chores. Oh, in addition to the last word, so we've got genre. Genre, so the type of film you like watching is the genre, if you like horror, if you like action. And the other word is gesture. 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 Bill would like to know how to pronounce the word vulnerable. 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 Thank you very much for sending those words in. Keep sending them and I'll try and get through as many as I can. If you have just joined us, this is Pronunciation Live on BBC Learning English. Don't worry, we will be posting the show up on Facebook and YouTube after for you to catch up on later. Okay, let's go back to some of the words that have been sent in. We have angle and uncle. Okay, so Pam Pam wanted to know the different pronunciation between angle and uncle. Also, let and leg. But Pampan, you might notice very often in English, let, we don't pronounce the T. So will you let me? Will you let me? Let me? The T is often dropped from the word let. And we've got leg. And the last two, Pampan, were bottom and button. So ah, bottom, and ah, this ah sound in button. Bottom, button. Okay, I hope that helps. Mara, thank you for sending in your words. We've got element and development. Element and development. The P is almost not heard there. Development. Element and development. Thank you for sending those in. Nitish wanted to give me a hard time today and has sent in this word. I'm not sure if you really needed to know how to pronounce it or you just looked up the longest words in the English dictionary and decided to send me that. So I'm going to have a go at this. It's pneumono, ultra, microscopic, silico, volcano, coniosis. It's not actually, it is in the dictionary, but it was an invented word, which is another word for this. So don't worry, you will never need to say this word, Nitish. You could just say silicosis, which is a disease of the lungs when we breathe in some small particles. So thank you very much for testing me today, Nitish. Chance sent in this word, shove. Shove. So again, this is this sound, shove. Shove. Maybe a little bit difficult, doesn't look how you might predict it to sound, shove, shove. So thank you for sending that in, Chance. Amit has sent in the words you will, and when we put them together, they are pronounced you'll, you'll, you'll. So you will becomes you'll, you'll. I hope that helps, Amit. Spring has sent in this selection of words. The first one here, which means a truth, is verity. 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 The second word sent in is discreetly. Discreetly. Be careful with the spelling of this word. There are two words in English, discreetly. If you were to spell it discreetly is when you do something quietly or secretly. The spelling that you have sent in, Spring, discreetly means individually or separately. So we are looking at the words discreetly, the sounds in the words discreetly. We'll look at them separately before running them together. The next word here sent in by Spring was utensil. Utensil, so a tool that you can use to help you do something, utensil. And the last word here was slurp, that sound that you might make when you are drinking something, slurp, slurp. Khada, thank you very much for sending in this word. It is prioritise, prioritise. So you've got an S at the end there, but it is pronounced with a Z, prioritise. Prioritize. Nipuni, we've had the word chores. Yes, chores are jobs that you do around the house. So you might call them house chores, house chores, house chores, such as washing up, for example. Sherrod would like to know how to pronounce the word entrepreneur. 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 Thank you very much. Monica, thank you for sending in this word. Whether you are male or female or something else, it would be your gender. 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 Okay. My salty boy would like to know the words, how to pronounce the word earth. 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 So remember in English, when you have TH, it's often earth. You often need to put your tongue to your teeth to make this sounds. So this is earth, earth. Okay, words that are easily confused. Even with native speakers, sometimes we have to ask for these words to be repeated to make sure they're clear. This is 30 and 13. 30, 13. So 30, the stress is on the first syllable, 30. And 13, 13, we stress the second syllable. We need to make that clear. Okay, Ninja would like to know how to pronounce the word exhaustive. Exhaustive. Okay. I think the word you wanted to say was overwhelming. Overwhelming pronunciation here is overwhelming. Thank you for sending that in. And Ezra would like to know how to pronounce the word equivalent. 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 Okay, in a couple of days it will be Saturday. 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 Cameron would like to know how to pronounce the word environment. 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 And Juan would like to know how to spell, pronounce these two words. We've got weather and weather. These are also homophones, which means they are spelt differently, but they have the same sound. Weather. Weather. Okay, we've dealt with Saturday. Should definitely clear this one as well. Sometimes difficult to pronounce because it doesn't look how it sounds. It's Wednesday. 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 I hope that helps. Okay. And we've got the word enthusiastic. I hope you are all enthusiastic about improving your pronunciation. Thank you, Minik Pom, for sending in medicine. 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 And Cameron for sending in adjacent. Adjacent. So the stress there is on the second syllable, adjacent. 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 Shanko would like to know if these have the same pronunciation, and they do. Right. Right, as in the opposite of left. And to write something, the pronunciation is right. I can, of course, help you to pronounce the word poem. Poem. If we slow it down, poem. Or if you want to say it quickly, poem. Poem. Thank you very much for sending that in. Monome would like to know how to pronounce the word ocean. Ocean. So it's got a sh sound. The s, the c makes a sh sound in this word. Ocean. 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 Fantastic. Okay. This word here is burlesque. 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 And how Indra would like to know how to pronounce the name of their country, which is in English is pronounced Nepal. 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 And Bill, one of my favorite words, Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Maybe you have been required to use some Worcestershire sauce in your cooking, but you didn't know how to pronounce it and ask for it in the shop. So there you go, Worcestershire. Worcestershire. Fantastic. All right, let's go back to our challenge today. Which of these words have the same sound? So we've had loads of answers coming here. Okay, so Bill is saying these two have the same sound and therefore are homophones. Natalia thinks it might be these two. Sandeep thinks it could be these two. Okay. Let's take a look at the answer. Okay, it is these two. So, number one, and I won the race. Okay, so the past tense of win is won, and we've got the number one. The other words, to take a look at these, we've got haul. Hall, H-A-U-L, hall, and hole, hole. Okay, so sorry if you got that wrong. They don't have the same sound. One is a or sound, hall, and the other one is hole, hole, hole. So to some people, they can sound quite similar. Hall, hole. So to haul means to pull something very heavy, and hole means total or complete. The second words we've got worth. So again, we're making that TH sound there, worth, worth, and worst, worst, worst. And finally, at the bottom, we have got live. If you are using the verb, L-I-V-E is live, to live. It could also be the adjective. You are watching pronunciation live, L-I-V-E, live. Live or live. But L-E-A-V-E is leave, leave. That long E sound, leave. So congratulations and well done to anybody who got that right. If you didn't get it right, don't worry. You can come back to Pronunciation Live on Tuesday or Thursday to practice your pronunciation further. I'm sorry if I didn't get a chance to get around to modeling your word for you today. But don't forget, you can join us next week and send your words in and we will try and get round as many as we can. So that's everything from me today. Thank you so much for joining me. Don't forget to access BBC Learning English, all the other resources to improve on Instagram, YouTube, on Facebook, Twitter, and of course the BBC Learning website. And I will see you next time. Thanks very much for joining. Bye-bye.